go up there north and up. To Art and Heart.
Where is that?
It's place in the big park in the Nuvik. I don't know what it's called.
Have you been to Nuvik?
Yeah. I'd like to go. I haven't been yet, so I'm working towards it. I'll go. Eventually.
It's cool on the inside here. So.
Yeah.
So you're,
I'm somewhere special. Everywhere I am is special.
Yes, yeah.
I'm there. I stayed very humble throughout that time.
Where is that?
It's place in the big park in the Nuvik. I don't know what it's called. Yeah, I'd like to go. I haven't been yet, so I'm working towards it. I'll go eventually.
It's cool on the inside here. So.
Yeah,
so you're,
I'm somewhere special. Everywhere I am is special.
Yes,
I'm there. I stayed very humble throughout that time.
Well, good morning to you, sir.
Hey.
That's really nice stuff you got there, these masks.
Thank you.
That's what they are, masks?
They are indeed masks.
Yeah, what are they made of?
All my work is made of paper that's at this table, but I'm skilled in leather making. I can work in silicone, latex, just about any medium. You dream it up, I can work in it.
That's great. Let me ask you who you are, what's your name, where we can get in touch with you, and tell us a little bit about yourself.
My name's Douglas. You can get in touch with me at schoolofwit.com. And my email address is douglas@schoolofwit.com. And I'm a professional mask maker. I've spent the last 17 years of my life honing my skill. Moderately trained, classically trained in formal theater arts, and mask making is my obsession. So these pieces here, which are made of paper, are sort of the form I work in. And I start off by doing a casting of a person's head, and then I take plasticine, an oil-based clay, and I start sculpting a mask. This piece here is an improvised piece. You may have seen some of the drawings earlier, and they're my concept drawings to get in touch with the show. And then they expand it from there. So basically what I'm doing is just sculpting right now. This is the clay mold part of the process. And then once I finish this, I will paper mache that and let it dry and peel it off and get something called a shell, which is... as it sounds, it's just the shell of what the mask used to be. And then I'll let that dry, paper mache it some more, and keep pushing it there until it's finished.
If somebody wants to have a caricature done of a friend of theirs for a birthday or an anniversary, could you do that for them?
I could definitely explore the idea. I'm more so a fine artist, but I can be talked into a lot of things. So absolutely, yeah, I would say give me an email, never hurts.
Okay, that's great. You want to give us your website again and email address and spell them out so that folks can know how to type them into their web browser?
Yeah, it's schoolofwit at schoolofwit.com. So school... of Witt, W-I-T-T, .com, and then my email address is Douglas, D-O-U-G-L-A-S, at schoolofwitt, W-I-T-T, .com.
All right, and you're here in Yellowknife.
I live here in Yellowknife. I'm a noob since this last year, but I don't plan on going anywhere anytime soon. I love Yellowknife, so I've decided to live here for the rest of my life.
All right. I heard something about you trying to travel around the territory next summer.
I teach workshops for schools and townships. I do ongoing workshops here in Yellowknife with NAC, but I get invited to go up to communities and teach mask making at their schools and in their community centers. I'm also going to be traveling north in hopes to do the Great Northern Arts Festival this summer. I'm also working on a self-guided art show called Turtle Faces, which is going to be a series of giant masks. And when I mean giant masks, there'll be masks the size of my back. They'll be huge. There'll be more fine art pieces. They're more interpretive pieces of the travels that I have in the far north and around Canada. So I travel all over Canada teaching masks. I've spent the last 5 years going from Ontario and teaching everywhere in between here and Yellowknife. So I just, I've got a stint down in Calgary coming up. I've been to Fort Providence and Fort Smith, and I've taught a lot in the Yellowknife here. So I'm looking to expand that circle and go as far north as I can. And there's no place that I won't travel to. I love the smaller the community, better. I try to always be invited to a place. I don't like showing up uninvited. It's how I am. So, yeah. I'm also First Nations Métis, so I like to try and carry on traditional mask making as much as I can, part of a Métis heritage, First Nations heritage.
Do you know where you're going to be doing the workshop in Calgary and when yet?
I'm working on a workshop in Calgary for a local high school there called the Canmore High School. That'll be a closed workshop, but I'm working on trying to get some public workshops with One Yellow Rabbit or Gross River Theater. So I may or may not be teaching there. So I haven't sort of settled those contracts yet.
Okay, good luck in that. Thanks very much.
Wow.
Thank you.
Oui, j'en ai donné un, mais il va falloir que je le reproduise. Là. Ouais, parce qu'ils sont pas. Au début, je les faisais très grosses, là, puis là, il m'a dit tu n'en finiras pas, il faut les faire très petits. Moi, j'en ai un.
So she doesn't want to sell. And now she just gave one away because you have to make another. You have to make the same one again.
À peu près cette grosseur-là. Puis au début, j'ai déjà fait. Comme de les mettre un produit pour les protéger, mais ça fait comme trop commercial. Tu sais, ça fait pas naturel, là. Je vais essayer de trouver un produit mort pour les protéger.
You had been putting sort of a varnish produce to protect them, but then it looked too shiny and commercial.
Okay.
So now she's going to try and find something more natural. Looks more natural.
Yeah. C'est des presse papier. Tu sais, les gens, puis je vais mettre des... les gens vont pouvoir se servir comme ça, comme presse-papier. Parce que tu vois, c'est comme un œuf, là, c'est des roches de rivière, tu vois, comme un insecte.
So it's like so these are river rocks. Yeah. So smooth and
that's like. Moi, je suis quelqu'un de pas patient. Je suis toujours là, quelqu'un qui va vite. Mais ça, là, ça me permet de m'arrêter puis de travailler là vraiment lentement.
So normally, she goes very fast, and she's not patient for these rocks.
She so has to be.
That's one thing that helps her seem quiet.
Yeah.
Ouais. Et quand le mariage?
Dans 2 ans, qu'ils m'ont dit, ils vont me donner la chance d'en faire.
You get that? 2 years?
Yeah.
That's a long time, so you have time to make your stones.
Ça se laisse le temps, là. 2 ans encore pour les produire.
Oui, oui, oui. C'est ça. Oui.
Ça fait combien de temps que tu as commencé?
J'ai commencé il y a 2 ans, mais j'ai arrêté aussi parce que j'ai eu le cancer. Puis là, je suis en rémission depuis 2 ans. Puis j'ai eu mes traitements, puis j'ai recommencé à travailler cette année, l'année dernière. Puis tu sais, ça m'a pris quand même un certain temps. Puis là, cette année, j'ai fait comme arranger un petit peu pour moi dans la maison. Puis là, je vais recommencer. Après ce voyage-là, là, je vais m'y mettre.
So she had started 2 years ago, but then she got ill with cancer. Now she's back to work. So she's going to set up, when she gets back, she's going to set up a little space in her house. And
yeah.
She's going to,
you need a big space.
Yeah.
She needs tools.
So it's intense.
So is this project for None of the
Time? Arts and Crafts.
None of the Arts and Crafts. Where is this? There's going to be a magazine or something?
It'll be like a...
Okay, well, I'll wait for you guys. So we'll be here in about 15? Yeah. Okay, got it.
Hi, that's really nice stuff. Tell us about yourself. What's your name? Where are you from?
My name is Laura Ettagiak Orchard. Originally from Taktoyaktuk, but I live here in Yellowknife. I've been here since 1990.
What kind of work? We see a few things on the table here, some beadwork and some mittens and other things that I don't really know what they are. What kind of work do you do?
I sew with furs, I embroidery, I make mitts, mukluks, which are boots, I make baby belts, I do beadwork, I make these type of covers for adults and children. I can basically sew anything that I put my mind to.
How long? How many years? I mean, the quality of your work, I think you've been doing it for a long time.
Well, it's about three or 4 years now. I'm getting better at it, so it's, I absolutely love sewing and creating and getting ideas from other people and being encouraged by other people sewing too.
I can tell. I mean, it looks a lot more than 3 years that you've been doing it from the look of the work that I see.
Yeah.
Who inspired you?
My mother.
I thought so.
My grandmother used to sew. She made a living sewing. Suzanne Ettagiak. My sister Elizabeth Drescher is a sewer. She's well known for her sealskin sewing, vest mitts. And it was a family tradition. My grandmother, my mother, she adopted me. Used to sew to make money, to make ends meet. And all the ladies used to do sewing and tuck to make money to get food. So that was one of the ways to live.
Yeah. That's beautiful stuff. Where can folks get in touch with you?
In Yellowknife. I live in Yellowknife. You can reach me. Do I give my phone number?
If you choose, I mean, you don't have to. Do you have an email address?
I have an email address.
That's probably a good idea.
It's taktoyaktuk@theedge.ca. And
if people don't know how to spell taktoyaktuk, they can find it on the web.
They can find it on the website or the maps. Yeah. Maps have the proper spelling for that. Yeah.
Okay. What's your name again?
It's Laura Ettagiak Orchard.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just so people know. So when they call you on the telephone or send you an email, they know who you are. Okay, thanks very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
That's what they call that.
Very nice stuff. I saw that you just got a sale too. That's good. Can you tell me a little bit about yourself and your work?
Well, my name is Roger Bisson. My company is called Artifacts.com, ArtAufax.com. I live in Yellowknife, Northwest Territories. I work with caribou, moose, and mastodon ivory. I work a lot with different types of antler. I make an assorted amount of products. I make a lot of stuff that leaves the Northwest Territories for tourism, corporate gifts, things like that. But I'm in most of the galleries in Yellowknife, some in the south. Now Fort Smith Museum has just bought a bunch for me, so now I'm going to be in Fort Smith. I go to all these sales, the Christmas sales, and I do a pretty good business. People seem to like my art, and I've been very busy lately.
How long have you been doing it?
6 years now. I ended up on a pension, so I've been home sick and what have you. I can't work anymore. I used to work in camps. I can't leave town. So my wife has pushed me into working on my own at home.
Pushed? But gently persuaded.
Gently persuaded. So I took up carving. I just slowly started as a hobby, and people liked it, started buying it right away. So I just went hard, and now I do this full time. It's a full time business.
Well, that's great. Can you give us your website again, and any other way we can reach you?
Artifacts, ArtAufax.com. I'm in a lot of the galleries in Yellowknife. My website's always being updated, so there's always new stuff on it. I guess if you're in Yellowknife, you can always call 867-766-4429.
All right, thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you.
It's a little blind.
Yeah, and then just don't rub it too much, and then decide what you want to draw with. Do you want to use the end of a pen or a brush?
What do we do? Is there a picture? Can you pass me that leaf?
Yeah.
I'll just take a look at it.
Yeah.
Or I could get you one of these pens. I guess this way you can't really see what's happening.
No, you just wing it. It's kind of
I
love it. That's nice.
Cool.
I love that. So do you want it, while that's still kind of wet, do you want to put another one on there and
sure.
try to get... And this one, you're going to either rub with a spoon or with the berry. But you'll have to stabilize it. Yeah. Just give it a good rub all over. Make sure, sort of imagine where the outline of the square is. Because it's the edges that...
Oh, that's too big.
I... Neat.
Pretty.
Isn't that neat how that does
that,
eh?
So lovely.
Hiya, that was interesting. I've now shown folks a couple of little demonstrations of what you do. So, you know, that answers a little bit about my question, and that's monotype? Does that have to do something with printing or typewriters or something? I don't know. What's monotype?
Well, sometimes the word monotype is often used interchangeably with monoprint. But a monotype is a one-of-a-kind, and I guess a type. It's not, you're not using a typewriter, and you're not using any kind of a plate, like a design that's already been done before. It's basically painting colors on, and then putting paper off, and pulling it off, and that's your design, and that's what you have. You can always embellish it after it's dried. You can add stuff to it, and I've just started doing that with this one, adding prints of a leaves on there, and I've done that before in some of the other pieces I have over here. They're very easy to do. Like some of these are ones that have been done by students. Like people have just dropped by and done them. They can be put to cards, add to cards, or even they're frameable. You know, you can do that as well. I don't know what else you want to see here.
Well, they're quite nice.
There's some
I see you can do multiple colors as well, eh?
Yes, you can. Yep. And some of them you can add later if you want. Like, uh-huh. For instance, this one that I'm working on right now, I've been adding some ink to a leaves and then putting it on here, printing, rubbing it off, and then I'll get the design like that.
Okay.
So there's lots of different things you can do. You can even, it's a good base for collage if you decide you want to do a collage sometime too.
Do you get this this ink? Can you get that in town someplace, or do you have to order it out?
I've ordered this out only because I also do lino cut prints.
Okay.
And this is printer's ink.
Okay.
And the reason I bring it here is because it's easy to work with, it's quick, and it's easy to wash up because it's a water soluble. Some printers like to use the oil-based ones because they don't dry so quickly, but if you're doing kitchen art, it's great. Non-toxic. Okay.
So
it works well.
Since you're doing some demonstrations here, and I saw when I was looking at your prints over there earlier that you have a sign-up book for workshops. I take it that you give workshops in this, or individual lessons, I suppose, if people would like.
If you like, what I do is I would start people off by just teaching the very basics, like those little demos that they were doing, and then I'd get to a larger.
Yep.
I would probably work with them to make a larger piece. Now this one's fairly dark. It's my arsenic and old lace. It's my mine shaft and a little bit of lace on the side. But this one I didn't use those particular inks. I used watercolors and I mixed them with glycerin and just... The nice thing about working with watercolors is that when you print it on the plate, which is what we call this, a plate, you can let it dry and then you wet the paper and then apply it and rub it and it comes off like that.
Okay.
And then you can always add things to it as well. I put some ink on lace and I rub that on like that.
And from the looks of it, you could add lines or with pencils or ink or crayons or anything that you felt like.
That's
with
right.
It.
Yeah. And this one, I like to use fern leaves once in a while in my work. So what I did was I laid a fern leaf on here and then I inked over top of it.
Uh-huh.
And then this is what they call a ghost print. There was still enough ink left on the plate, so I ran another one over it. That's what they call a ghost print.
Well, that's nice stuff. And for the north, it looks like it's really good too, because I guess you could do that inside in the winter without too much of a problem.
Absolutely, and it doesn't take up much room. And it's easy to clean up. Children love to do it, and it's quite a nice. It's fun. It's very unpredictable. That's what I like about it.
I see that. I like that kind of thing too. So now time for the commercial, and that's who are you? Because I forgot to ask you that right off the beginning. So my apologies for that. And where the heck can we get in touch with you to take these monotype courses from you?
I'm Diane Mercredi. I live out of Yellowknife. I live about almost 40 kilometers out of town. I do have a studio out there. And I can do monotype workshops. I can do lino cut workshops. I also work in oils and acrylics and watercolors. So if there's an interest, I'm very prepared to do workshops either individually or with groups. I could be reached at, I don't have a website, but my telephone, I can be reached at 867-444-8029.
Okay, could you repeat that so, nice and loud?
My cell number is 867-444-8029. And my home number is 867-873-1112. That's an easier one to remember.
Okay, okay. So you do individual workshops, group workshops, and gee, I guess if there was someone having a corporate gathering in town, you wouldn't be against going and doing a couple of hours of break between their tedious meetings for them to get the group working together on a project.
I'd have no problem doing that.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Diane.
Thank you.